Memorizing the planets is one of the coolest things you can do, but I found acrostics very, very complicated and not as easy as some people say.
Like, my very educated mother just served us 9 pizzas.
Has some problems. For example, which of my and mother belongs to Mercury and which belongs to Mars? Does anybody even know? And how could you tell from the acrostic itself? Not only that, but what if you want to add more information about Mars and Mercury, or Venus, or Saturn for that matter? You can't, because an acrostic isn't flexible enough as a memory technique for memorizing the planets. So in this video on planet mnemonics, we're gonna take acrostics and go out into the vast solar system of memory techniques to find the ultimate truth, because it is out there. And then when you use it, you're gonna have an amazing experience, perhaps like the experience that I'm gonna share with you when I used a particular kind of mental structure to help me remember the classical
solar system
used by the Hermetic memory masters to meditate upon the nature of reality and heal themselves. That's coming up in this video. And you know, I make free education like this because I believe you should have it. So if you want to be part of the Magnetic Memory Method community and you're new here, make sure to get subscribed, hit that thumbs up, and join us at magneticmerrymethod.com, where you will find the portal to our inner circle. If you're ready to cut through the noise of all this crushing, overwhelming, free information and find a place where we meet month after month for encouragement, guidance, special topics in memory and learning at an accelerated rate and in a way that is truly meaningful in a world that seems so complicated and strange. So that's at magneticmerrymethod.com. Now, what are we gonna do to make our memory better than just using acrostics, which ultimately get dated? I mean, my very educated mother can serve us all the pizzas in the world, but what are we gonna do with that when new heavenly bodies are discovered? You gonna make the sentence longer when Eris and Mackie Mackie appear on the scene? Ultimately, as cool as acrostics can be, I don't think that they are profound, because you not only can't change them very easily if new information arrives or information has to be deprecated, and the way that you can do that is something that when you learn it will enable you to memorize multiple facts about each and every planet, and you can use it to memorize multiple facts about anything in the world. So that's called a memory palace. And imagine that in this room, or the room that you're in, you mentally assigned little stations that you can travel mentally, and that's where you're gonna place the planets. Now, as of today, when I looked up the bodies that are considered planets, they had a list of 13 that I found. Wow! Very, very easy though. Just think of this room. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
And to look at it a different way, you could see that your kitchen might work very, very nicely. And for that 13th station, you don't have to have a full column. You could just have one area, or you could make it 13, 14, 15.
And on each of these little stations, I could place the names of the planets in whichever order that I wanted. So let's just say I started with Mercury and I put it right here. Now, how am I gonna remember that it's Mercury right here in this room? Well, I could see a Mercury automobile that is driven by the god Mercury. Very, very easy. If I have Saturn over here, well, there, I mean, I know a store in Germany called Saturn, which, you know, is very, very simple and direct to use that, but I could also have someone named Sam sitting on an urn. Now, it's in the past tense, but you know, the brain can work that out, Saturn. And maybe he's turning the urn while he's doing it. Or Eris, for example, it can have Nike Air shoes that are, I don't know, risible, if you know that word. If you don't know a word like that, you could think of something else. You could think of maybe a name like Eric, and he's meeting someone named Christian, etc. The point is not to be creative. but rather to dig into each and every word and figure out either something that you already know to make the association and place it in space, or if you don't already know something, try to find the easiest thing that you could know. So if I didn't already know about cars called Mercury from the past or the god Mercury, I could look into the spelling of the word and just start with M. I would think of maybe M&M murmuring, or I would think of a mermaid, a specific mermaid, like from The Little Mermaid, Ariel, I think. Now, Ariel might be a thing that could help with Eris, and that would be a nice choice. But, you know, it depends on your age and you just have to think a little bit about it, you know. So I think of Merv Griffin, and not everybody's going to know those associations. But if you really just look at the letter, Curie, Marie Curie, Mercury, you know, it's close enough. And if you don't know this, you could always go to the great engines of search and say, okay, gods of search, I need something, word that sounds like Mercury, or, you know, name that starts M-E-R, or something that rhymes, you know, there's rhymezone.com, and you can find these ways as you gradually train your brain to do it for you. The more you practice using these techniques, the more the associations are going to come. Now, there is another thing that I wanted to share with you that I was playing around with. I think you're going to find it interesting and maybe something you might like to experiment with as well, because experimentation is really how we expand our skills with the memory techniques, and we learn more about what they are and how they work, which is why I myself wanted to experiment with this. Now, content may be king, but context is God. So let me explain a little bit about why I'm doing this. There's a book called The Magic Door, and in it, it's talking about the Italic Hermetic tradition. And this is, you know, quite an interesting book. You may or may not find it interesting, but it has mention of the classic solar system that was used by certain practitioners of the Hermetic arts. And as I was reading David Pantano's The Magic Door, I thought it would be pretty cool to remember those seven classical planets that the Hermeticists used and create a little meditation for myself that might help with some things that I was doing, and also a little bit of help with some research that I was doing for a novel that I'm writing. So what I did is I created a body memory palace, and I started with the list in order that he gives for the seven classical planets that they used, and I placed Saturn over my head, Jupiter directly on the top of my head, Mars on my mouth, the Sun on my chest, the Moon on my belly, Mercury basically on my hips, and then Venus on my thighs. Now, there's no good reason necessarily for those to be the places that I placed the planets, other than the list appeared in the book from the top to the bottom, those planets, and then I just thought, I know how to use a body memory palace. These are the stations that I typically use, so I'll just place them in that order. And a neat thing that came out of this is that I also wanted to remember what Pantano says that these planets represented symbolically for the Italic Hermeticists. And it just happened that there were just some nice parallels there, as if it was guided. No, I don't think that was the case, but it was just a nice, happy circumstance. For example, Mars, which wound up on my mouth, it is a symbol of the will and willpower. And I thought, isn't that cool? And it helped me remember it instantly, because I could meditate in my hermetic meditation that I had the willpower to keep my mouth shut when I need to. And that's just a neat little thing, because where better to have such a reminder than on your mouth itself? I think it's Proverbs 18:13, to answer before listening, that is folly and shame. Something I memorized in a memory palace, a more traditional memory palace, but what a wonderful thing. The Mars willpower on my mouth. And I won't go through all the whole list, but there are different things that these planets symbolize, and there were other interesting parallels. Now, you might be thinking, you just said that Venus was on your thighs. Shouldn't it be around your hip joint? And yeah, okay, that might have optimized it, but that would be out of order with the list. So I just found that a really, really neat thing to do, and you might want to, maybe you read the book, maybe you don't, but you might want to think about how that you could use your body as a memory palace. And as I said, I'm cooking this up for a novel that I'm writing as well, where some of my characters who are involved in investigating crimes and so forth are also involved in something related to the planets. but more news on that coming as soon as possible. So it's all fine and dandy that my very educated mother just served us 9 pizzas. Thank you, Mom. But I hope that you have found this alternative approach useful, interesting, compelling. I want to give you another little suggestion here, but I want to thank everybody who has hit that thumbs up, gotten subscribed, who supported this channel by being a member on the channel or getting one of my books or one of my courses. And I know many of you have done all of those things, and I'm very, very grateful. Everyone on Team Magnetic is grateful because it enables us to keep bringing you content. Speaking of content being king and context being God, I mean, I don't know that there is a God or not, but something has enabled me to put out a lot of content, and it's just a great, great blessing. And I love to cover every single possible angle of memory that I can, and to do so in a way that is thorough and deep and gives you new ideas, ways that you may not have considered before. And one of the reasons that I'm able to do that is because so many of you constantly feed me with interesting, compelling questions or different requests for things to cover and so forth. And obviously, if I don't know a thing or I'm not going to be able to do a decent job at it, I won't be able to do that, or I just will choose not to, just simply because, you know, we've got a little bit of a moral compass here, including Venus on our thighs. But you know what I'm saying. It's just a great blessing to be able to do this, and I just am very grateful. So here's one more thing that I hope you'll also experiment with, and it is really just simple. Try and use a planet itself as a kind of memory palace. Now, we have some indication that this was done, at least with the moon, which I suppose is not a planet, but it is a heavenly body. But some of the ideas that you might want to explore are in Hilary Gatti's book about Giordano Bruno's relationship to science and astronomy. Very, very good. But the most specific reference that I know to the use of a heavenly body like the moon as a memory palace, which could easily work on any planet that you cared to familiarize yourself with, is in the Hermetic Art of Memory. Now, I would just encourage you to go ahead and get this book and read it. It is kind of next level. It is in a language that's a little bit older, but the translation is excellent. So I don't think you would lose in any way by making sure that you've read The Hermetic Art of Memory.
But if you want to make sure
that it truly is something for you and discover one of the most extraordinary memory techniques in it that I unpack in some detail. At least it was an idea that inspired me in the same way that I took inspiration from the magic door that I talked about earlier. If you want to know more about this book, watch my full review on the Hermetic Art of Memory next.